Join the private sector energy efficiency movement led by the National Business Initiative by plugging into energy efficiency and stem the tide of rising energy costs.
So that's the one thing about changing behavior. Operational efficiency is basically, like we said earlier, it's about matching your usage to your requirement, being operational efficiency. Okay. So it's being saying, well, if I need only 100 liters of water, I shouldn't be pumping 150 liters of water. If I need to heat up something to 50 degrees, why am I heating it up to 75 degrees, for example? You know, those type of things. So it's matching your usage to your requirement and saying, how can I be more efficient operationally? Okay. If I need to produce 100 products, why am I producing 120? Maybe because there's some poor quality products. I need to get. When you produce poor quality products, what happens? You use energy, isn't it, to produce a poor quality product. You use resources, or whatever. And then you throw all that away, and then you have to make it again. So it's additional energy, additional resources, costing you money, isn't it, as a business. So quality control is quite important, just from that point of view. So just by having good quality control in your business and reducing waste saves you energy. Okay. So just those basic things. I mean, this is not rocket science. But it's just understanding those things, okay? So typically, operational efficiency is normally also quick to implement. Sometimes it hardly costs you anything. Maybe sometimes you just maybe put a few plans in place, or maybe put a new control system in your business, for example, to make it more operationally efficient. And doesn't sometimes cost you a lot of money, okay? So normally these things are quick to implement as well.